Welcome to the Mariah Carey reading. I promised somebody very special and long dead that I would not do Mariah Carey, but somehow I feel like just breaking the rules. I just do. So welcome to the Board of the Bantu and to the Mariah Carey reading. I shall make it quick. I shall make it quick. I shall make it quick. Okay? I will make the Mariah Carey reading very quick. I will. So, Mariah, where's her picture? Where's her picture? Let me get her picture. I gotta look at her picture. Mariah Carey. There she is. Okay. All righty. And welcome to the first celebrity who has wings. Mariah Carey has wings. Okay? Unbelievable. She has wings and she is resplendent. There's no other way I can describe this lady. Her light is amazing. She is sparkling. She is literally sparkling, like she literally floated into the room and she is sparkling and I am stunned. She says, I say, hi, Mariah. She says, hello. You're talking about me when you are the same. I can't see myself. Sorry, we're giggling. Well, I can't. Okay. And I'm sitting and you are floating. She says, we do suffer, don't we? Yes. We have suffered. Yes. Oh my God, I'm tired of suffering. I'm tired of suffering. And she says, the big billion-dollar question is, are we human? My question exactly. I've been asking that question for a while now. Are we human? She says, do you have an answer? No. Do you? She says, no. And she laughs. So, Mariah Carey. I mean, what else can I say, people? This is Mariah. Welcome to the board of the Bantu. She says, thank you. So, Mariah, please walk into our room of light. And she walks into the room of light, and her light dims, obviously, and she's now in a black gown. Her hair is straight and silky, and she's a little darker in the metaphysical than she is for us. And she sits down very gently. Black to us is the color of life. Okay, that's why I wear black. White to us is the ethereal color. Some of our tribes get buried in white. So, I wear black for life. Okay, white for power. Alrighty. So anyway, sometimes white is for power, sometimes white is for evil. Anyway, Mariah is sitting and she is looking very ladylike and she is smiling at me. And she says, you like my composure? And I say, yes, I do. She said, it took many years. It took a long time. A girl from the ghetto. Human trash. I had to clean myself up. And it wasn't easy. The world is so easily fooled. They want to believe what they want to believe. That's true. She says, Nick broke my heart. She's talking all by herself. So I'm just gonna chill right here. I'm totally gonna chill. She says, Nick broke my heart. It was my last chance. My last chance at happiness, husband, and home. What did he do? He cheated What didn't he do? He had more sex with other women than with me. He would go on about how fat I have become, how old I have become, how much I drink. He did not understand my traumas. He did not understand that sometimes I have to bury myself in alcohol. Don't marry a younger man. If you do, don't make him too young. At first, I was so happy with him. We had all these plans. We were going to be the power couple. We're not going to lie like the others do. We were going to live in our reality. But no, he sure likes them light-skinned girls. I should have known. So, you know, I'm just chilling right now. Getting to know myself. Getting to appreciate myself and how hard I've worked and what I've been through. What have you been through? A lot. There are some things I'm not going to talk about with you. Understandable. Tell us about your childhood, Mariah. It's in the book! Didn't you read the book? No. What is there to tell? It was full of prostitution and child abuse. I ran away from home. Lost my innocence too soon. Always running away, coming back, running away, coming back. My voice was the only thing I had to take me out of that mess. I was taken advantage of by those in the industry who thought they could. Is one of your ears deaf?